So what does the future look like for digital art? There's a new craze in the crypto world, and it's called crypto collectibles, or NFTs, non-fungible tokens. The market has been growing from just $41 million in 2018 to $338 million last year. Well, this week on June 24th, that is this Thursday, an NFT is dropping, expected to be the biggest NFT art sale in the Philippines. Joining us to talk about this would be Filipino visual artist Luis Buenaventura. He's also among the first NFT artists in the world, publishing his work back in 2017, and also, wow, the highest earning NFT artist in the Philippines. And of course, we have FinTech Philippines Executive Director Amor Maklang. Amor, Luis, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Morning.
Good morning, Mimi. Good morning, Luis.
Okay, so I guess let's start with Amor. Amor, how does releasing art via NFT change the game? We understand, you know, artists can be paid directly, but what other ways does this change the way things normally go for art and artists?
You know, I remember that very day because I got so many messages from our community, both in fintech and technology and the financial services. March 2021, 69 million, I think, in a digital auction. The highest
for a digital
artwork. I still get goosebumps thinking about it. You know, no, seriously, because the Philippines is one of the top, not just one of the top art markets in the world, but more importantly, proud to say, and we've talked about this several times, one of the top three global markets for crypto, only second after Nigeria and also after Vietnam. No? So the thing is, this is really changing the way art is being produced. Ownership of art is being done. And this really paves the way for a different, an altogether different asset class to come in and finally be taken seriously. Final point is, you know, everyone's talking about blockchain and crypto and how it's also hypothetical. This is an actual use case. And, you know, we have Filipinos like Luis. I'm so kilig that he's here today, right? The highest performing artist in the Philippines. So we're all holding our breath for what will happen on the 24th.
Okay, Luis, let's get to you. Clearly, you are the star of this Thursday's show. What are we expecting in the NFT auctions this Thursday?
Thanks, Mimi. Well, I mean, you know, so this Thursday is going to be a really important day for the NFT scene in the Philippines, but also kind of on this side of the world, no? Because traditionally, NFT art has been very much centered in North America. And because of the way that this particular new marketplace is situated, it's going to be very open and accessible to this side, Asia, you know, kind of all of the artists that are here in the Philippines, in Indonesia, in Vietnam, in Thailand, all of these countries are suddenly going to be able to have access to this stuff very directly. So it's going to open up the market even wider. It was already quite large just with the North American investors, but now this side of the world is also going to be able to participate.
Okay, Luis, Amor, I'd like to direct your attention to this video we are going to play. This is one of the works of Luis that will drop on Thursday. This is 2K. Let's watch this. Okay. So this is pretty much the 2K. Luis, just very quickly, if you could give us an idea, how big is the community of artists of NFT? And if I want to buy, what's the difference going to be? It's a digital artwork, right?
I think the most
like this one that we're showing.
Right. I think the most interesting thing about NFTs is if you can think about them first as a digital certificate of ownership. No, and if you think about it that way, then what they are is proof that this artwork was created by a particular artist. It's proof that that artwork was then sold to someone else. And it's proof that that person possibly resold it in the future to someone else. So it's kind of like this decentralized way to track all of that activity. And if you think about digital art just in general, we've never had anything like that before, because you can make all of these copies of digital art, and suddenly now you can prove that one of those copies is the official copy, the one that is kind of endorsed and created by the artist themselves. And that's kind of it's so specific.
Yeah. I was going to say, you know, Luis, for the longest time, one of the reasons why photography can't really rise to the level of paintings is because of the perception that they can be reproduced and reprinted.
For sure. Yeah. And it is one of the main problems that, you know, that NFTs are trying to solve. Because, I mean, digital artists should be no different from traditional painters or sculptors or any one of those other, you know, kind of more classic vocations. The difference really is that because our work is so easily reproducible, it's, you know, kind of the market just kind of thinks that it's not worth as much. But I think what we're proving with NFT art is that it is exactly worth as much, if not more.
And we just showed the 2-4K. Am I allowed to ask you the price that you're going for this piece of art?
Well, we're going to find that out on Thursday. And with a lot of these NFT drops, it's always auction style. So in other words, you kind of set a floor price and then you kind
of... So what's the floor price?
You'll see soon. You'll see soon.
Okay. Why do I get a sense it's very high? That's why you don't want to share it. But anyways, it is art. You know,
It's single edition.
Just one. And right. Whoever wins it will get that certificate of authenticity. Okay. And just so, how many artists are into NFTs now? Do we have an idea?
So that number is a little bit harder to guess, no, but I would say tens of thousands all around the world. I mean, here in the Philippines, definitely still in its infancy, maybe a few hundred, but you can kind of see it already kind of, you know, getting a foothold just because, you know, the market's never been open this way for Filipino artists. It's the first time that we've been able to kind of offer our work on such a global stage. And it's a very unique time to be doing this stuff.
And Amor, when you look at the market of buyers, what sort of demographics are we looking at? Is the market big enough here in the Philippines?
You know, oh my goodness, you know, the size of the, let's just start with crypto users in the country. I know for a fact that one exchange, and there are several exchanges in the country, already has close to 250,000 users, even actually more than Tabi-Tabi Po, even more than online stock trading in the country. So let's just start with that universe, right, of crypto users. You know, and Binance is actually, correct me if I'm wrong, Luis, the biggest in the world. So your market is all of a sudden exponential. But just here in the Philippines, easily could be 500,000 people in crypto who are eligible to buy and bid on the 24th. Yeah. Not to include art collectors, the brick and mortar art collectors.
You did mention Binance. I understand Luis is one of the first few artists, NFT artists on Binance.
Yes. Yeah, that's correct. And kind of it was a very, you know, big honor to be one of those 100 creators that they're going to be launching this new marketplace with. So this is kind of like this is a new set of doors for Filipino artists. And that's what makes it so special. I think that, again, it's the globalization of our art that is suddenly made possible by this stuff. And we're no longer going to be limited by the fact that, you know, I mean, I live in La Union, for example, so I don't even have access to a lot of the kind of very direct centers of art, even in my own country, right? But like, I'm competitive with the rest of the world because everyone is kind of on a level playing field suddenly.
Mm-hmm. Final question, Amor, just very curious. For example, what about artworks that were finished or completed before NFTs were even built? Like if you have a painting, a Monet painting, for example, and suddenly they create, can somebody just create a digital form of the Monet painting and then they auction it off and then suddenly two guys can own the Monet painting? One can own the physical art, the other can own the digital version? Is that how it works?
Allow me to share with you something a little bit more mind-blowing, right? So the idea of co-creation and collaboration is really what makes this era for artists and technologists truly exciting, no? Mm-hmm. So say, for example, you have an artist, a traditional artist, let's just leave it at that, and even a dead artist whose estate perhaps decides to collaborate with an NFT artist, then that basically is another permutation of the type of art, right? You can embed it with music, you can embed it with dance, right? You can embed it with whatever. It could be, the Monet painting could be turned into a music video, right, Luis?
Yeah, for
wow.
sure.
Wow. The extrapolations are so wide-ranging. Thank you so much, Amor and Luis, for joining us. Looking forward to finding out how much we're going to fetch on the NFT drop this Thursday. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Bye, guys. Thank you.